This is a demonstration on how to use a rubric to grade a discussion in D2L version 10.3. I need to make a special note that this is not a demonstration for using group discussions. This is just for single discussions. There's a separate video on how to use rubrics with group discussions. So I'm going to go over to the discussion area. And I'll find my topic that I want to assess. So in this case, I've already attached the assessment, but I'll just show you where you go to do that. So you would go in and you would edit this piece, go to edit topic, and go to the assessment tab. On the assessment tab, you can choose which grade item it should be associated with and the score. However, you do not add the rubric here. So just the grade item and the score, and then you would save and close. And you would need to do this for each topic that you're going to assess. So you can see here for the memo, I've already included the assessment on that one as well. Now, to attach the rubric, you're going to go over to your gradebook. Here are my grade items that we just looked at for the email and the memo. So I'm going to go and need to edit this item. You could also do this right when you're creating the item, but since they're already there, I'm going into the edit. You can see I have already given it a name. I have already attached a point value. And I need to scroll down just a little bit where I can then see where I can add the rubric. So I'll click Add Rubric, and now you need to find the rubric that you want to use. This class happens to have a lot in it, but the one that I want is called Weekly Discussion. Now for this demonstration, I've already got the rubric created. Really, you'll need to view a separate demonstration on how to create a rubric. This is just showing how to grade with one that's already there. Add selected, and save and close. Now I'm ready to do my grading. When you're using a rubric, you need to grade from the gradebook rather than grading from the discussion area. And you'll see why here. In order to let the student see how you've used the rubric, it will only show up if you use it from the gradebook. Even though you can attach a rubric to discussions, as we saw over here, it allows you to attach the rubric, but there's nowhere in the discussion area for students to be able to see how you used the rubric. So you don't want to attach it here. You want them to be able to see which boxes you clicked and how they were evaluated for each level of the rubric. So don't use it from the discussion area, go back to grades. And when you're ready to assess, you see you can tell when a student has participated in this discussion because this discussion is linked to the gradebook. It will show up here. So when you're ready to put in your assessment, you will go to the grade item, go to grade all. There's the little icon again, and here's the rubric. So you're going to have to go to both of these pieces to enter a score. So you can click on the submission icon to view all the posts by that one student and determine how you want to grade them. Keep in mind the items that you're looking for in your rubric. And then you can either move that off of the screen or close it. But then to use the rubric, you click on the little assessment icon for that student. Now this is a very simple rubric. Yours probably have a lot more detail, but you can see I can grade here the original post, and maybe I'm going to give him this response here for the reply that he did, and it gives you a total point value. You'll need to remember this point value. So this student is getting 8 points, and I'll save this. That saves the rubric, and now I can close it. And remember, that was 8 points. You do need to enter the 8 points on the grade sheet. It doesn't transfer it. So this is a relatively new tool, and I think that's why some of these things aren't going automatically like we would want them to. But you can kind of get the idea anyway that you have to click on the bubble to view the posts, then close it, then click on the assessment rubric to evaluate that, and then enter the score and save. And then I would hit yes. And let me see what other students have replied here. So I could go for this student, trainee one. I can click on the submissions and I can scroll through here, view everything that that student has done for this particular topic. Then go over to the assessment rubric, make my assessment. You can leave comments here even. If you click on the little pencil, it allows you to give some feedback. You could even go up here and say, you know, really, I want to give this student 4 points. You can even change the point value. Leave feedback on why you took a point off. Save it. It adds it up, so you need to remember the 9 points. Save. Close. Enter the score and save. So that's how you would grade a regular discussion. This is a discussion that's open for the entire class. First of all, going to the discussion board and linking it to the grade item with that assessment tab, and then going to the grade book, attaching the rubric to the grade item, and then doing grade all and using your little icons to enter those different pieces, or to see and to enter. Now, just as a final note, I want to show you what it looks like to the students. So I am in now as trainee one, and I'm going to look at my feedback. So if I go to my grades, I can see the grade that I got for the email, and then under comments, if I would have left additional comments, they would be there. But the rubric shows up under the assessment details. So then the student clicks on assessment details and it pulls up the rubric and shows exactly what was given in each of these areas. Let me know if you have any further questions about this topic, and look for the other one about group discussions. Thanks.